Sharks. My name is Lauren Pidauer. I live in Cordova, Alaska, where I am both the founder and owner of Alaska Glacial Mud Company. I'm here today seeking $100,000 in exchange for 20% of Alaska Glacial Mud Company. As a commercial fisherman, I know Alaska is already famous for wild salmon, but someday, I'd like to see us famous for a luxurious and nutrient-rich Alaska Glacial Mud. The idea for Alaska Glacial Mud Company started on a wilderness rafting trip down the majestic Copper River. As soon as I stepped in, my feet sank into buttery mud. It was such a divine sensation, I proceeded to cover my face and body in the silky mud at the most wild spa in the world. After washing it off, my skin was soft and glowing. I want to see this amazing mud become an industry standard in the spa market. So, Sharks, who wants to get their fins dirty and play in the mud with me?
Are you the only one that ever discovered that this was the best mud in the world?
There is no other Alaska Glacial Mud products on the market.
Lauren, can we see it?
Absolutely. For you.
Thank you.
There's a mixture here of some of the different products we carry.
Thank you.
Thank you, Lauren.
Mr. Wonderful.
Thank you.
Barbara.
Nice to be.
Mark.
Have you processed this mud in any way?
It goes through a refining process to ensure quality control.
I'm worried that a big bear would have taken a large dump near where you were.
Oh, God.
It's the cleanest mud in the world. It comes from one of the most pristine wild rivers in the world. I would actually really like to have Mr. Wonderful come up here
Whoa.
And give you a glacial facial.
Okay, then. I just hope I'm not being covered in bear poo.
Oh,
no,
God.
This is very pure.
How long would you need to leave it?
In order to dry, it would take about 10 to 15 minutes.
Does it draw the impurities up out of your skin?
Absolutely. It contains microfine clay particles that absorb toxins and exfoliate dead skin.
Somehow this looks like the true you.
All you gotta do is draw some horns on him and he's set.
What other body parts can be used with this stuff?
Top of his
The color of money.
Yeah.
The color
it's
of money.
Very cooling. I feel the toxins leaving my body.
The Copper River, where this comes from, is an incredibly pure and wild place, as you all may know if you're fans of Copper River salmon.
How much are you selling today, and how are you selling it?
Our sales to date are $36,000 a year.
Oh, $36,000 a year.
Do you have a small shop, Lauren, that you sell it in?
No, I do not have a retail shop. We wholesale it to spas.
In
we
Alaska.
We wholesale it all over the world.
Your real target that you most want are the spas?
Yes. I'm interested in the spas, but there's a lot of products on the market that people buy for themselves at home. I mean, especially in more depressed economies, people who can't afford to go to a spa.
What does that jar sell for retail?
It sells for $34.
And what does it cost to make one jar?
About $3.
That's good margin.
It's hard to crack into the spa market is the problem
it's
because
so hard.
There's so few products
so
that spas
hard.
Carry. They'll usually carry one product and then endorse the line. So I understand why you're having a problem getting in. It's a really great concept, but there's hundreds of people that want to get in, but so few that ever can. And for that reason, I'm out.
It does take a lot to break in this industry.
Yes.
And
how much money have you put into it, Lauren?
I've put $50,000 into the business.
Where did you get that money?
That's from money that I have saved over the years. Fishing is where I do make my income. The fishing is only 3 months out of the year.
Scary, isn't it, when you put up everything you have? How much money do you make on the fishing side?
I gross a little over $100,000 a year.
Wow.
You bring in $100,000 a year?
Yes.
That's incredible.
I want to buy into your fish business.
Do you fish alone?
I fish alone.
Really?
Wow.
You're a beast. Congratulations.
I am a risk taker. It's largely a man's world. There's seven women who professionally commercial fish in the town that I'm in. But this is something that I really felt I could do. And it was naive to think that I could go into this and build the business slowly and organically.
One of the biggest challenges is making the decision when to grow something organically, just grind it out, or to spend a lot of money and go big. and then create pull-through demand. Mm-hmm. You've got to connect to something that's already in place so people can connect it to you. You might want to look at changing it to Copper River glacial mud or something to leverage it.
I think it's a good idea.
But because there's a big leap from where you are to where I think you need to be investable, for those reasons I have to say that I'm out, Lauren.
Alaska's hot right now. Alaska tourists spend over $300 million a year in products just in our price range.
So, Lauren, your mud may actually be better, but the consumer walking into the spa doesn't know that. But
I need your help. I mean, I have been working really hard to make this happen.
No, I hear you, but you could spend millions to educate a market. You can't go global when you're doing $36,000 a year. I'm out.
Okay, thank you, Robert.
You've got a lot of good things going for you.
Thank you, Barbara.
And you have a great story. I could see you hanging out with the bears.
I am a very
on the sleds with
person.
The dogs and by a beautiful river.
I want to make this happen.
I invested in a company called Nardos, exactly the same space you were in about a year and a half ago, and I've learned a lot of things about the cosmetic industry. Here's the thing. It's very hard to be retail and spa. You have to figure out what your market is, or you're going to waste a lot of money. I wish you the best of luck, but I'm out.
Okay. Thank you,
Barbara. Well, Lauren, you've got
I have
Kevin.
Mr. Mudface left.
Kevin has never looked better.
My other problem with it, none of the other sharks picked up on, but anybody can go pick up mud out of the Copper River.
Right. They're going to go up there and say, get out of the way, Lauren. That's my mud pile.
They're going to squash me like a bug.
No. They've already done that. Tell me if this is not the truth. You're taking a successful business, your fishing business, and subsidizing, so far, an unsuccessful one. I have a saying, any business that after 3 years is not profitable is not a business, it's a hobby. Look, I can't go down the river with you on this one because I've got mud on my face. Okay, look.
I have companies
look, Lauren,
from China
I've looked
Japan.
For every possible reason to invest. I'm out.
Thank you. Well, thank you all for your time.
Thanks,
I really appreciate it. Thank you. Ciao.
Good luck.
Ciao. I'm amazed that she goes out alone and fishes. That is amazing.
I think I didn't get a deal today because my sales just weren't strong enough. But I'm going to charge on and build the brand regardless.